Hi, I'm Jaye with Wilcox. Today we're going to be talking about the RAID XE, the Wilcox Ruggedized Aiming and Illumination Device. The Wilcox RAID XE utilizes the latest in VCSEL technology, that's vertical cavity surface emitting laser, to project infrared light onto a target in the clearest, farthest reaching, and brightest way possible. First thing that we're going to do is unbox the unit. We're going to show you what to expect when the unit arrives to you, what to look for, and the major components that are included in the packout. The first thing that you're going to notice is that the unit comes shrink-wrapped in a slipcase box. We also have the Wilcox hologram that lets you know that it's factory sealed and ready to roll. All right, so we're going to start by opening the unit up. All right, so as soon as we open the box, the first thing that we have is our product insert. We also have the RAID XE toolkit, and then finally we have the pouch that houses the unit itself. Now that we have our components out of the box, we're going to take a closer look at each individual component. The product card that comes with the RAID XE is a list of the feature highlights that set the unit apart from other laser aiming devices on the market. Next up, we're going to talk about the toolkit that accompanies the RAID XE. So in the toolkit with the RAID XE, you're going to find that it's got our lens brush here, our lens cleaning cloth, and then the RAID XE tool. All right, so for the RAID XE tool, it's got three heads on it. And basically what we're going to be using this for is mounting, as well as if we want to change out the lenses and attach a different junction box onto the unit. We're going to be talking about the junction box in a little bit more detail, as there are some variations that might suit one user better than another. But for our purpose right now, this XE tool is what we're going to be using to make modifications to our equipment as well as mount it. Okay, next we're going to talk about the RAID XE itself. So it comes in this pouch. You're going to notice that it's sealed with this tag. On this tag, it's got the serial number and the QR that's going to take you directly to the operator's manual. So we'll just pop that open, and then now we've unsealed our unit. First up, we're going to lay out some of the components, and then we're going to talk about some of the features for the unit itself. First thing out of the bag is going to be our laser safety visor. This is our hard plastic component, so that's going to be our protective plastic covering for our lens. It ships with the rubber safety visor, but depending on your preference, you're able to customize and switch that out. Next up, we have the unit itself, and it's going to come with the Wilcox Ergocto pressure pad already attached. Following that, we have the Wilcox junction box blank. So the blank is something that you're going to be able to use to sub out if you decide that you don't want to use the pressure pad. You have the option of disconnecting it and inserting the blank in its place. This is going to protect the unit from damage as you're operational with it. You also have the option of getting a dual cable connection. The dual cable is going to have the Ergocto 3-button pressure pad, the junction box connector, as well as the secondary cable that can attach to your flashlight. Wilcox developed the RAID XE to be as modular and customizable as possible. To that end, you also have the option of getting a junction box that's going to allow for the fit of a crane connection port. This is going to allow you to use a legacy remote when operating the RAID XE. Following that, we have the pressure pad rail adapter. That's going to allow you to mount the pressure pad on the rail itself. Now we're going to talk about some of the basic features of the RAID XE. So the RAID XE is an ergonomic, low-profile, ruggedized aiming and illumination device. Currently, the RAID XE model that I have in hand is in our tan or coyote pattern. The unit is also available in black. It's equipped with a near-infrared aiming laser, a near-infrared illuminator, a visible aiming laser, and then a room flood. The room flood is a lower power light that doesn't cast any bloom in your night vision goggles when you're in CQB. The RAID XE is going to be available with red or green visible aiming laser. If you get the red laser, it's going to be 75 milliwatts, and the green laser is going to be 12 milliwatts. The near-infrared aiming laser is going to be 30 milliwatts, and then that near-infrared illuminator is going to be 50 milliwatts. The RAID XC features VCSEL technology. That's a vertical cavity surface emitting laser. The VCSEL allows us to cast infrared light out to distance with the ultimate in beam clarity. So with the laser safety visor removed, we're able to see our co-aligned optical bench. The co-aligned optical bench means that 1-0 for the unit, using these adjusters here, elevation on top and windage on the side of the unit, are going to apply to all the lasers in the unit. The RAID XC also features an environmental sensor. This is going to track the ambient light and adjust the menu brightness accordingly. This can be overridden in the menu settings, which we'll get into. But if you'd forgotten and you need low light, then you can simply shift that shroud down, and that's going to obscure some of the light that the menu outputs. As we go along the unit, this is the battery compartment. The RAID XE utilizes a CR123 battery. Next up, we're going to talk about the function switch. The function switch is equipped with a high power lockout screw. This is going to prevent accidental engagement of our high power lasers while we're in a training environment, potentially causing injury. When we move up or forward on the switch, we're going to engage our infrared lasers. We have aiming low, illuminator low, and then we have dual low. The dual low option is going to enable us to cast both our aiming and illuminator lasers at the same time. The illuminator at low power also has a menu function that enables you to toggle between the illuminator at distance and the illuminator at short range. That's our room illuminator. When we have the illuminator enabled, we're going to be able to control the divergence here with this wheel. The divergence wheel is going to allow us to open that aperture up from 2 to 6 degrees. If we disable this lockout screw, we're going to access our high power functions. We can take that lockout screw and store it here in the illuminator divergence wheel. With the lockout screw removed, then we're able to scroll up to our high power options. Aiming high, illuminator high, and then illuminator dual. And again, that's going to enable us to cast both lasers at the same time. If we were to scroll down, which is towards us, then we're going to access the visible lasers. The visible laser is going to be low power and then high power, which is also disabled by that lockout screw if it's in place. You have the option of activating the unit with the 3-button pressure pad. You can also activate the unit with this fire button here. The fire button, when pressed once, is only going to have the lasers activated while you hold the button down. If you release it, they'll turn off. To get those lasers to stay on, you're going to double tap it. So a quick succession of taps, and then the laser is going to persist. In order to turn it off, all you have to do is tap again. Next up, we're going to talk about the menu function on the RAID XE. The menu featured here has a shroud so that if you're in a low light condition, you can simply move that shroud and that's going to dim the light automatically. You can also control the brightness of the menu by accessing the menu functions. In order to access the menu functions, you're going to hit the top and bottom arrow at the same time. So once you push those two, then you're able to access the menu, and from the menu, you're able to control the brightness of the unit itself. Once you've activated the menu, and then you've hit enter on bright, you can scroll down and select your option. You can select dim 4 through 1, and then bright 1 through 4, as well as auto. If you utilize the auto option, that's going to use the RAID XE's environmental sensors to scale the brightness of the unit. Once you've scrolled to the option that you wish to see, go ahead and hit the enter button. The next menu feature that we're going to talk about is setting the laser ID blink pattern. To set the laser ID blink pattern, you're going to activate the menu and then scroll down to blink. There are 6 programmable ID blink rate patterns: fast blink rate, medium fast blink rate, medium slow blink rate, slow blink rate, fast with double blink, and slow with double blink. The default option is going to be a persistent laser, no blink rate at all. You can also use the menu to select your low power illuminator. Your low power illuminator is going to be your room illuminator. What you're going to do is scroll down to Illume, press enter, and then it's going to allow you to toggle back and forth between short and long illumination. You also have the option of utilizing this function without the need to access it through the menu. With the function switch set to IL, if you press and hold the enter button, then you're going to be able to toggle back and forth between short and long, and that'll read out on your display. If it's short, the room illuminator is going to be enabled. If it's long, it's going to be your variable divergence illuminator. Another feature of the menu is that you're able to program the three-button pressure pad. The three control buttons on the pressure pad are ergonomically designed to allow for accurate button identification. Once you've selected the remote feature on the menu, you're going to see options 1, 2, and 3. 1, 2, and 3 are going to allow you to assign a function of the unit to each button of your pressure pad. This allows the end user to set up the remote any way that they choose. This is going to allow them to focus on what they're engaging rather than what button does what at a critical moment. Next on the menu is the screensaver. This function is going to allow you to set the amount of time that the unit can be inactive before the display is going to turn off. This is going to allow you to still operate the lasers on the unit, even though there might not be anything present on your display. The default is going to be a 5-minute power off. You can also set it 1-minute, 3-minute, 5-minute, or 10-minute. You can also completely disable the sleep mode, and the unit is going to remain in continuous operation. If there's an error in operation of the RAID XE, you're capable of conducting a self-test to assess the unit. The test function allows the operator to perform tests against the internal hardware to ensure proper operation. It consists of multiple test steps, and a message is displayed at each step. Once you've selected Test, press the up or down button to step through the tests until the final screen is displayed. The final screen will display Done, All Passed, if it's passed, or Done, and then the number that it failed. If you continue to press the up and down button, the testing will be repeated. If you'd like to restore the unit to its factory defaults, which is going to clear your laser ID blink pattern, restore the auto brightness, and then return your screensaver auto off to 5 minutes, highlight default in the menu. Once you've highlighted default, you have the option of hitting enter on reset, or if you'd like to cancel out of that and keep your functions as programmed, hit no reset. The next menu feature is going to be the maintenance counter. This is going to count the number of times that the laser has been activated on the unit. The events function displays up to 3 events categorized by their criticality from low to high as follows. I is going to be informational, W is going to be warning, and E is going to be error. You can refer to your manual for code definition. The about function allows the operator to display unit information. The information is displayed on 2 screens. The first screen displays the software revision, hardware revision, and battery percentage level. The second screen includes the unit serial number and model configuration. So we're using the XE tool to switch out the junction box. There's one screw at the top of the junction box. We're going to unscrew that, and then all we need to do is simply remove the junction box. From there, we're going to take the blank and we're going to simply plug it in, and then we'll screw it in. One thing that I'm going to want to make sure that I do is that the unit's seated securely in the back end, and I am applying pressure with my finger so that when we screw it, there's no gap present as it's seated. So what we're going to do now is we're going to swap out the laser safety visor. So for this, we're going to use our XE tool and the smallest attachment there. We are going to gently unscrew here at the base of the unit. You'll see 2 small screws. And then once those are removed, we're going to go through swapping out completely. Remember not to over torque it, because sometimes that strips out the screw. There's our second screw. Then we're going to apply a little bit of pressure from the back there and then slide that off. So once we've removed the rubber laser safety visor, we can take the hard plastic, and what we're going to do is, as the unit is closed, we're going to be able to just shift it onto the unit, and then we're going to make sure that it's seated properly up here so that this seam lines up completely and there aren't any gaps. Once we've done that, we're going to be able to screw these back in. Remember, they don't have to be any more than slightly hand tight. If you over torque it, you're going to strip out the screw. So with that replaced, now we have our laser safety visor. Now we can talk about how to properly mount the RAID XE and the pressure pad to a weapon. We have a standard 1913 Picatinny rail, and then we have, on an M-lock, we have the Picatinny rail adapter. That's where our pressure pad is going to go. So what we need to do is first mount up the RAID XE. So we're going to do that just like this. Make make sure that we have our XE tool handy, and then we're going to tighten these screws here. The thumb screws, torque spec is going to be 30 inch pounds, so we're going to tighten them down, make sure that they're gripping nice and tight. That's going to help us maintain our zero as well as ensure that the unit stays on the rifle itself. One of the added features that we do have on the rail grabbers for the Raid XE is this, where we can have a lanyard attached or wire if we need to ensure that if the unit is dislodged during operation, we're able to retrieve it. So first thing that I'm going to do is take the Raid XE pressure pad Picatinny rail mount, and I'm going to seat these rail grabbers here. Once the rail grabbers are seated in, next thing I'm going to want to do is take the screw here, and I'm going to just slide it in a little bit. And then I'm going to take the included Allen or hex key, and then I'm going to tighten them. When these screws are tightened, you want to make sure that they fall below the surface of this pressure pad mount. So here we have it. And then all we're going to do is use this part to slide in here. So I'm going to use a little bit of force, push that forward. So once the pressure pad is set up on the adapter, you're going to use the zip ties for your wire management. So real quick, all I'm going to do is just thread this through. And then we're able to trim those ends off as well. So once the Raid XE is fully mounted, you have your pressure pad set up, you're going to be able to operate the unit instinctively, head up and eyes out. The Raid XE offers the ultimate solution for the end user who requires flexible illumination, ultimate beam clarity, and user-defined functionality. Be sure and subscribe to our YouTube channel to find out more of the happenings at Wilcox Industries and some of our other featured products.